At a field hospital in Havana, Cuban health workers learn how to treat patients with Ebola while keeping themselves safe. These doctors and nurses will soon join their colleagues in West Africa on the front lines of the outbreak. The Cuban government has made one of the largest commitments of medical personnel to combat Ebola, garnering rare praise from usually adversarial U.S. officials.
If we don't adequately address this current outbreak now, then Ebola has the potential to become a scourge like HIV or polio that we will end up fighting, all of us, for decades.
While Ebola is striking fear in countries around the world, it is also creating unusual alliances. On Saturday, former Cuban President Fidel Castro engaged in some Ebola diplomacy himself, writing that Cuba's health workers would, quote, gladly cooperate with their U.S. counterparts to stop the spread of the killer disease. Fidel Castro did not spell out how the U.S. and Cuba would work together, and it's unclear if Washington is taking his offer very seriously. In 2005, Castro also volunteered to send Cuban doctors to the U.S. Gulf Coast to help with the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina, a gesture that U.S. officials ignored. Cuba's once model healthcare system was laid low by the collapse of the Soviet Union. Still, the island continues to send doctors to countries ravaged by disease and natural disasters, says the official charged with training Cuban doctors to fight Ebola.
Nosotros somos un país pobre.
Our principle has been to share what we have and not to give what we don't, he says. The little we have, we share. Our principal resource is human capital. Nurse Carlos Garcia fought the outbreak of cholera in Haiti, and he volunteered to take on Ebola in West Africa. If it could show up in developed countries like the U.S. and Spain, it can show up in underdeveloped countries too, he says. Our families are at risk as well.
La capucha.
On Monday, Cuba is hosting a regional conference on how Caribbean and Latin countries can work together to counter Ebola's deadly advance. Further proof that the specter of the epidemic is slowly trumping politics to bring countries together. Patrick Ottman, CNN Havana.